Born Matsuo Kinsaku around 1644, Iga Province, Japan, later known as Matsuo Basho, being the most famous poet of the Edo period in Japan, also known as one of the greatest poets in Japanese literature. As a child, Basho became a servant to Toto Yoshitada, who also shared a love for haiku, noregna. This was a form of poetry named the Heiku, which had a sequence verse of 5-7-5, which was later named Haiku. Basho also became the original master of Heiben, which are short poetic sketches that involved his haikus. The haiku became a form of artistic expression Matsuo Basho used to simplify the meaning of life. Basho traveled and went on many journeys to find peace of mind, which later influenced his poetry. Oko no Hosomachi, the narrow road to the deep north, is known as being the loveliest works of Japanese literature. Matsuo Basho later died November 28, 1694, in Osaka. His grave is known to be in Otsu, Shinga Prefecture. Before Matsuo Basho's death, he accomplished outstanding work with his literature. Every day is a journey, and the journey itself is home. This poem is one of Basho's most well-known poems since many individuals became inspired after reading his literature. Books were also published, which clearly allowed the audience to understand his journey as a poet. How many, many things they call to mind, these cherry blossoms. Matsuo wrote this haiku in dedication to his dear friend Yoshitada after his death. As children, they would both look at these beautiful cherry blossoms in amazement. A bee staggers out of the pony. This haiku represents the theme that although fear may be a trait of the unknown, it is essential that you go beyond your imagination's limits. Exploring the unknown results in complete freedom with no limitations. Sick on a journey, over parched fields, dreams wander on. The last and final poem by Matsuo Basho presents his eventual death, but within this final moment, he reaches to his same dreams that will forever wander on.